God has blessed you with some beautiful children. A lot of grandchildren are coming. You already have. God has blessed you with them. Guess what she told me? She told me my greatest joy, a source of happiness in life, is when she sees anybody that has never been, or anybody that the whole world, in a way, have written them off, that nothing good can ever come out of them. When he sees people like that transforming, then her joy is full, her happiness is full. That is godliness in her. That is love that radiates in her. That is compassion. That is empathy. I want to thank the Hebrew family, even led by Barrister Tony Hebrew. We all know how successful they have been as a family. We all know how impactful they have been in this nation. We all know that they were all pioneers in their different fields. They've taken up a lot of innovative ideas. They pioneered a lot of good things in life. A lot of people in this country have passed through their dynasty and they have become somebody in life. We are all here today. We should all think back. Why are you in this world? The most fortunate set of people in this auditorium are the youth, especially the students of this great institution. You know why you're fortunate? You have role models to look up to. You have role models filled in the entire dynasty of the entire Igbo family. What do you want to become in life? You need to start planning your life now. What do you want your life to come out to be? Is it the area of education, politics, entertainment? What do you want to pioneer? This life, we will all come and we will leave this life. We will hand over to generation yet unborn. But what do you want to be known for? Here is a family that we all here celebrated. Here is a family. But their name will forever keep ringing, even in the midst of generation years of God. What do you want to do for yourself in life? Let me tell you the truth, and nothing but the truth. The youth of this country, they own this country. This country does not belong to the elders of this nation. It belongs to the youth of this country. It's about time for the youth of this country to have that sense of ownership, to rise up to what belongs to them naturally. The dynasty built by the Ife family are good avenues for the youth of this country to naturally claim what belongs to them. If you occupy a place and 8 people out of 10 people that are occupying our place, they are connected in terms of their sense of race. Whose voice will be the loudest in that room? It's the Ife. Who will be the dominant factor in that room? The Ife. It is the youth of this country that still keeps this nation together because of various activities that they engage within themselves, one way or the other. This country, over 60% are under the age of 30. 30 years old, from 18 to 30. What good thing can they say about this nation? Who are their models? Who are their role models? Who are they looking up to? How well have they prepared themselves for leadership positions? It is in this life of ours that you will start having leaders between the age of 30 to 35 within this nation. I am prophesying today that very soon the youth of this country will start to claim what rightfully belongs to them. If the youth in this hall, I want to hear your voice loud and clear. If you say you don't want to vote anybody to power, so be it. If you say you want to take this country to another level, so be it. You are the activity that even the elders of this country look forward to. The other side of it, to destroy this country, it is the same youth they will go back to as agents of destruction. We should all come together and say enough is enough. You cannot tell us what we should be doing. We will be telling you what we want. On this note, I want to appeal to you that beautiful initiatives like this, you should be part of it. Education is very key. Exposure is very key. That's the only way you can claim your entitlement. That's the only way you can be who you want to be in life. We're celebrating a beautiful institution today. If you read about the resume of late Honorable Michael Ife, look at where he started to become someone in life. He is a pleasant memory today. His brother is here. Read about him. Look at the age the two child of what they've achieved in life. The same for Dr. Cecilia Igbo. Look at what happened to her at what point in her life. Let us all give them time to go and rest. Let us give them time for them to be in that elderly position. All you need is a blessing. The youth of this country, please come and take charge. We're here to uphold this beautiful heritage in this university. If I start to talk about the co-founder of this university, I will go on and on. I want you to go and read well about that. There is nothing she puts her mind on. There is nothing she touches that doesn't come to gold. She has put all her energy, her mind, our strength into the dynasty of Michael and Cecilia Igbo. As a co-founder, they have built this great institution. I have moved around, marked my walk by the very special grace of God Almighty, come to this university in another 3 years. You will be shocked beyond your imagination. In less than 5 years, this university will become a household name in Nigeria. It is my prayer as the spiritual head of the race, one of the most populous races in the world. I have prophesied and have prayed for this institution that will continue to grow from round to round. Very impressed with what I've seen so far, to the extent that I feel your 10 million naira endowment fund is too small. That's my personal opinion, and I know that in no time subscribe. I am part of it. I will contribute to it. I will be a very strong advocate of it until we get to the destination we're going to. We are very good people in this country that are doing great things. Irrespective of challenges, irrespective of what the environment must have brought to your table, the system might have frustrated you, but I want you to rise up again. Don't let that bring you down. If you truly believe in the system, you can do it over and over again. Dr. Cecilia is a living legend, a living example of great things in this nation. Look at what she's doing for the entire people of America. Look at what she's doing for the entire Europa Kingdom. for the entire country, Nigeria, and the people of Delta State. May God Almighty continue to be with you, guide and protect you, and all your generation and the generations coming through you yet unborn. Today is a memorable day. Like I said earlier on, I met the students yesterday and I prophesied to their lives. This institution will bring out doctors. This institution will bring out ministers. This institution will bring out female governors of this nation. This institution will bring out female president of this nation. This institution will bring out great, vibrant, energetic leaders of tomorrow of this country. And so shall it be. On a final note, I want to thank all the elders that are here present. I want to thank all the leaders and captains of industry of our dear nation. My advice to each and every one of us is, let us believe in this country. Let us believe in this country. And let us believe in this country. We don't have any other country. We don't have any other way to go. Stop making money in this land and you will continue to spend it outside the shores of this land. It is not good. It is not adding value to this nation. It is not making any impact in this nation. What you are going to see in foreign universities, you will see in Michael and Cecilia Andrew University. Let us support our home. It's a shame, a big shame, because we are not laying good example for the youths that own this country. You spend the money that you are making outside the land that is blessed to you. Please believe in this country. You are not making that money outside this blessed land. The land is green. The land is blessing you. The land is blessing each and everything you are doing. The land is blessing each and everything you lay your hands upon. Remember the land. The land too has a spirit in it. Stop cursing the land. Stop using your mouth to say negative things about the land. The land, you might think, is not looking at you. That land is looking at you. That land is looking at everything you are doing. That land is just there, looking the way you are being trampled on that land anyhow. Believe in this country. The land that is blessing you, remember to give everything back to that land. We don't need that land to just let you rest. Give back to the land that is blessing you in everything you do so that your dynasty can be sustained. Let the youth take over. Go and rest very well. God bless you all and God bless you all. The university is a piece of hard work for the students, for them to see the impact of my presence here today. It's a piece of hard work from the background of our heritage, the background of our ancestors, what we're known for, and that's what I presented to the university. On this note, I want to thank you for